Hello, fellow dungeon delvers, and welcome back to Planescape Torment. Last time, we made our first steps into one of the first dungeons in Planescape Torment, and we find ourselves in front of this, which seems to be some kind of mysterious coffin, and there's some writing on the walls. The script on the wall is in a long-dead language. It appears to show the life progress of the inhabitants of this tomb. And does that... Like this says, yeah. Okay. So basically, these are the history of the people in the connected tomb, I assume. But we can't read it. So, I guess you guys waited long enough. Let's crack this thing open and see what's inside.
I'm gone.
Well, there's a thing inside. This is the corpse of a man with a surprised look on his beak-nosed face. It's hard to tell how he died, whether from the numerous horrific slashing wounds across his abdomen and throat, or from blood loss occurred when his right arm was nearly severed from his shoulder. That's a bad way to go. If I could talk to him, he'd surely have a hell of a tale. Well, do we have that ability yet? Let's see, I need... Nope, that's the wrong thing. Sorry, guys. I'm struggling with what the key bind was. Nope, that's not it. Nope. There we go. Dialogue, special ability, raise dead. I don't think we can use this on him. Nope. Okay, so after all my fumbling, it comes to nothing.
All right.
So let's close this back up. At some point, you do get the ability to talk to dead people or dead creatures. So at some point, we'll have to do that. And I forgot to set my timer, so I'm with you guys. There we go. Alright, so that was a little bit of a downer, but at some point we'll be back once we can talk to dead people and we'll continue on. This leads to the Shattered Crypt. Okay, well, before we leave this area, I want to kind of explore the rest of it, make sure we clear everything we need to out of it. So let's do the proper thing and left-hand this. And what I mean by that is anytime you're in a maze-like situation, it's best to put your hand on one of the walls and just keep following it until you find your way out. Oh, what do we have here? A were-rat. Well, we don't have any silver, but I have a feeling that's not gonna matter.
All right, done.
Oops. Why don't I attack him, please?
My bite's not working on this. My bite's not working on this.
Weapon's not doing a damn thing.
Oh, it does matter. Well, let's see. What do we have? A green steel dagger. And crushing damage. See if that does anything. And if not, we might just have to...
I'm hurt. Away. Damn.
All right, guys, come on. Everybody get in.
Bite's not working on this thing. Bite's not working on this. Talk about beating a dead horse.
All right, so where rats are lycanthropes.
We lost you for good this time, Chief.
And lycanthropes need to be hit with silver things. I don't have any silver weapons at the moment. I think Dakin's blade is considered silver. For the purposes of overcoming damage reduction. Ooh, I forgot about these. These are Vargulls. And hopefully we can beat them up. Or else we can't go. That looks like we can actually beat the Vargulls. Nope, Dakin has fallen. I will be there in a minute. Forgot to change my equipment, so.
Die.
Okay. what most things are, after they calm down a little bit, is they're like vampiric heads. And every night, every day they maintain a human body. And every night, their innards become engorged. Oops. And they have to fly out and find prey as vampires. Okay, we have our raised dead ready. Do it on Deccan. Okay, and he's back. And we need to rest. So I am going to try and do this quickly, but we need to rest for a bit to regain our hit points. Cannot rest in this area. And I think these guys are going to be difficult to let me back through. The door is locked. The guard straightens up. You got what Farad wanting, Burke? Yes. Show it to me, Burke, and I'll raise the gate. But not until then, alright? Alright. Don't have it, but I do have something you might be interested in. Yeah, what that might be. Jink, how'd you like 10 coins? Don't think so. Now's 25. Getting warm, Burke, but you ain't there yet. 50? The smile wreathes his ugly face. That's good enough. Pass it through and I'll open the gate for you. You know what? I don't want to give him 50 coins, so we're going to do this. Have him reach for it. Grab it, and it's yours. He reaches through the gate for the coins you pulled out. Grab his arm and pin it. You deftly pin his arm back against the gate and wrench it. The guard screams in agony as his arm creaks in its sockets. Let me in, or I'll break it off. He hastens to open the gate before you make good on your threat, and stands far out of your reach as you pass through the gate. You ever cross me again, and they'll be picking your limbs out of the 3 different crypts. Understood? Good. Alright, so I don't feel bad about threatening that dude. They're kind of jerks. And I need to go rest. So that means I have to come over here to...
I'm gone.
Oh, where is her shack? There we go. Murda will let us sleep in her house. And I'll be right back after I've rested. Okay, guys, I'm back. You actually have to talk to Murda to rest in her house, but we are filled up, basically. I think Dakin's still missing a few hit points, but we're basically there.
Done.
And back into the dungeon delve we go.
Alright.
So, well, let me check the merchant real quick, see if he has any silver stuff. Because if I'm fighting werewolves, I need silver weapons. Let's trade. Rags, iron spikes, steak knife, knife, stiletto, knuckles, green steel dagger, green steel knife, sledge, not charm, charcoal. No! There is no silver. Okay, so for now, we are going to have to avoid the were-rats, but it's okay. I believe we have other places we can explore for the moment.
I'm gone.
Get back here.
I'm gone.
I wish I could just...
Forced it. I'm gone.
Ah. So that's what happens if you open the door yourself, is the guards will actually attack you.
Awesome.
that.
Alright.
I'm gone.
Down they go.
We're I'm gone.
Take their junk, because they don't need it anymore. You know, sometimes I like playing
sure,
a good guy,
not?
And sometimes I'm just like, I just need to be lazy. I don't really want to talk to you guys
I'm gone.
Time. I want to open this door. So, laziness wins out. Okay. Now back to it.
All right.
Let's see if the Varkles have respawned. Ditch. Rusty dagger. And like I said, I don't remember if I need the skull for anything, so I'll leave that here. Okay, so we can go any number of directions. Our left-hand method led us into were-rats, so let's try the right-hand method. We'll follow this.
Did you see that?
Hey, okay. We see her enemies. Die.
I feel stronger.
I have a level up, so let's go to statistics. Level up. Alright, so I've been neglecting. Skills have improved. I've been neglecting. Oh. Okay, so I remember one characteristic point gained. Saving throws have improved, I only gained one hit point with that, and that sucks. And my fighting skills have improved. Okay, so there are trainings that you can get done for specific weapon types. I think I have to find trainers to improve those skills, though, but I thought there was something on the level up screen. Okay, so I get a attribute point. Well, we rely on my strength a lot, so I'm going to increase that up to 16. Plus 1 to all melee damage. We will accept that. And then, so, I have 4 unused slots, which, like I said, I think I need to find a weapon trainer to use these proficiencies. So, we'll look for that at some point once we're out of the dungeon. Is anybody else leveling up? Nope. Okay. Continuing on into this vampire-infested tomb.
Damn it!
Okay. Wounded again. Dead again.
I'm hurt.
Going to run away because I am hurt now.
All right.
Just need to get away from the bulk of them and do some hit and run tactics.
Okay.
I'm hurt.
Oh. Okay.
Nope. Select them all.
What's up?
Need you.
Good as done.
To run a distraction for the moment.
Did you see that?
Okay. Ah, there
talk
you go.
About beating a dead horse.
Okay, so that's
you
a
snore.
Minor
really
inconvenience
loud.
For the most part. Let's see. Hotbar. Special ability. Raise dead. Deck in. Clot charm and some bandages that he can use. Okay.
Done.
And back into the fray. We've already killed most of these, I think.
Did you see that?
Let me make sure that he spends more time behind everybody else. Okay.
I hear your words.
Some more bandages. Okay.
Done.
Hey, something to search. A claw. Oh, yeah, I forgot I had stuff I could actually sell while I was up topside. Okay, it looks like this is another exit to the Crypt of Dismemberment. This is to the Shattered Crypt. So I'm going to keep looking down here first before we exit.
Done.
Actually, what was this? It's Buried Village, Crypt of the Embraced. Okay.
Done.
Ah, there is something right here, I believe.
I'm gone.
Yeah. As you pass one of the twisted stone faces on the walls, it calls out to you in a creaking voice that sounds like the shifting of boulders.
Immortal, regard me. I am Clive. I would have words with you.
How do you know I'm immortal?
I see a burning purpose within your shell. I see many things in the falling dust of these tunnels. You lack something essential, and that keeps you from death's sweet embrace.
What do you want to say to me?
Listen, this place holds much danger for you. Treachery awaits you on the surface, and your way is long and winding. At the end, you will find what you have sought, but you may not want it then.
Are you some sort of Oracle?
Oracle? No. I observe. That is all.
In that case, perhaps you can answer some questions I had.
What do you want to know?
Tell me of yourself. How did you come to be in this situation?
I was once respected leader of my community in the lower ward. A petty lord sought to increase his power at the expense of my people, my friends, my relatives, and friends, and I spoke against him.
And then what?
And then he captured us, one by one, and bound our spirits and senses into these screaming faces under the ditch where all filth and sigil comes eventually. And then he let the polluted waters above flow through our mouths and noses and eyes.
Is there anything I can do to help?
I am cursed to remain here until fresh water passes my lips. There is a magical
madness there.
There is a magical flask of water in the drowned nations. Bring it to me and give me a taste of it, and I shall tell you of someone who can help you unlock its full potential, and you shall never lack for water again.
Where is this flask?
Updated my journal.
I do not know. There was an artist named Chad who frequented these tunnels. He knew. Find him, and he may tell you. And how do I get there? Through the dead nations, where the dead walk and rule. Or through the warrens of thought, where many as one hold sway. Neither is without its risks.
Okay, so I can ask here about this Dead Nations and the Many as One. The Dead Nations is an underground city of undead creatures, and Many as One is a collection, a huge collection of cranium rats. So, with that, I think I'm not going to ask him any more questions. The voice I have chosen for him is very hard on the throat, and we are reaching our time limit anyways. So, we got a new quest. Let me finish up this. I got it. Farewell. Alright. So, with that, I'm going to call this an episode. So, as always, guys, thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time on Planescape Torment. See you then.